Welcome. So today we're doing the Phantom Bot Draft. So it's using Baldur's Gate. So this will be my first attempt at one of these drafts for Baldur's Gate. We'll just see what we get. So I guess it's a Phantom draft, so you don't want to... I have to get out of the habit of rare drafting. Because you're not keeping the cards. Worth looking at this rare though, so Gorion, Vigilance. When you cast an adventure spell, you may copy it and choose new targets. So that seems good. That seems good value. 3/4 for 3. It's just it's three different colours, so you're kind of committing to a three colour deck quite early. Okay, so it finds a plains if your opponent's got more lands. So it's not the best land fighting card I've ever seen. Usually they're not conditional, they just let you grab a land. It's weird how it's... Oh no, you do. Okay, it does ramp the land onto the battlefield. That's the difference between this and the artifact creature that just looks for a land and you put it in your hand. So yeah, that's why that's good. It can ramp something into play. 3 cards for 3 life and 4 mana. It's pretty good. Right, Liara of the Flaming Fist. This is really good with all of the double team cards. And yeah, you can give things first strike and double teams. This is an incredibly good card. Really good uncommon. Okay, the ability you can only activate once. Right, okay, that's not quite as ridiculous. It's still really good for a 2-drop. I think that we're more like... I think this is stronger than Gorion. It's just the power of this card is much less conditional. This one, you've got to draft loads of adventure spells. You might only get 3 or 4. And from the adventure spells I've seen, it's things like Ettercap. How often are you going to get to kill 2 flies with the Ettercap? Not... maybe 1 time out of 3. It's not going to be that. So I think this... we ignore this rare, to be honest. I'm just going to double check everything is working well. Yep. Right, I'll be surprised if there's anything better than Liara of the Flaming Fist. It's a nice 1-white removal spell. But yeah, you need a bunch of creatures for that to work. We've decided Eyes of the Beholder is a terrible removal spell. 6 mana is far too expensive. -11/-11 sounds pretty impressive, but you know there are black removal spells for 2 that say destroy target creature, so... I guess, -11/-11 gets around invulnerability and regeneration. I don't think regeneration is a thing anymore. Grim Bounty is really good. That's going to be definitely one of the best cards in the pack. And Ettercap seems pretty darn good, to be honest. Just sometimes it'll kind of just be a 2/5 creature because your opponent's not playing any flyers, which is still fine. I mean, yeah, 2/5 for 5 mana is maybe not that great, but flyers tend to be pretty popular in draft, so it's most games, sort of 2 games out of 3, it's going to get some pretty good value, I would say. Yeah, let's go ahead and get Liara. We've got the freedom of not having to rare draft, so let's build a stronger deck. This is a white uncommon, and it's good. There's a lot of powerful creatures, I would say, in the set. I think that's playable. And the Scry 2 is really nice. I reckon that's a good removal spell. Innkeeper we like. Blue land, right, Ranger Squadron has double team. It's a good common, but yeah, it is expensive. So I think we leave this as a last pick. We hope it wheels around. I guess this is an alright combat trick. It's got one of these boon effects, which is quite good. Young Blue Dragon's pretty nice, pretty nice adventure effect. Now, Kobold Warcaller, we've seen people use this to quite powerful effect. I suppose there are quite a few cards it's quite similar to. I think there's a Kaldheim card for 2 mana that can give creatures haste. I suppose the difference is this can target something in your hand and give it haste, so it could be that big creature you're planning to cast on turn 6. I think it's really good. It's quite tempting. So maybe I ought to pick the Warcaller, but I think I like the Guiding Bolt too much. I just like removal spells. Rescuer Chwinger has got flash. And you can bounce things, okay. Kind of cool. Pretty expensive, this one. Ah, Soldiers of the Watch, they've got double team. Pretty awesome, pretty solid card. Unexpected Allies is another way of getting double team as well. This seems like a really good combat trick because it's giving you card advantage. Okay, Cloak of the Bat gives haste as well as flying. That's pretty good. It's a little upgrade for that kind of equipment card. So, Soldiers of the Watch, pretty good, very tempting. Probably ought to pick them. But I think I want to try out Rescuer Chwinger. I'm just going to, because it's an uncommon, I'm going to try out the slightly off the wall cards, I guess, a little bit. Right, Goblin Trap Finder. Cool. It dies and you get a card. Oh. The card you get has sacrificed this creature. I wonder if all of those effects are copied by Double Team. Be cool to find out. It's kind of a life gain. We do like Dueling Rapier. Jaded Sellsword, another unexpected ally is and a young red dragon, which is pretty cool. Okay, I'm gonna. I want to try out this the Trap Finder. Ah, Fire Beetles are pretty cool. Kobold War Caller's pretty cool. Yeah, Steadfast Paladin. This is expensive. Oh wow, that's a one white adventure just to give something indestructible. That seems cool. 2/3 flyer. But I think I'm going to go for the Mephit's Enthusiasm. That seems cool. We're building a fast deck, so that guy might be good. Good removal spell. Does 5 damage for 2 mana. Young Red Dragon's pretty good. Flyer. I think I want to try a really quick deck. Definitely this could work if we're playing a lot of creatures. Utility card could be handy. Another Patriot's Humiliation. We can go for the Hawk and see if we can get it to trigger and ramp us out some mana. We just go for another of these removal cards. I think let's at least try them. Then we're going to get the late picks. So I think definitely that's a good late pick, the Ranger Squadron. Why not Guardian Naga as well? Dueling Rapier, fantastic. Oh wow, and even get another removal spell. Sure. Bargain. Fiend Lash. Artifact equipment. So a red source of reach. You don't see that every day. That seems cool. So, yep, 3/3 creature, some removal. We're definitely going for this Fiend Lash. That sounds cool. Pretty sweet. Bounce a creature. buff. There's Lantern of Revealing, that which is another ramp card. Don't think I play that. I think, yeah, let's grab the Lantern. We want to go for a more of a mid-rangey, rampy kind of deck. Battlecry Goblin. Makes creatures. Really good. Take that one. That was a very loud goblin sound. Pegasus Guardian can save things. Can make Pegasuses. It is very expensive. Might be the best thing here. Jaded Sellsword. We're not bothered about that. We'll take the Pegasus Guardian. Maybe we can make this removal spell work with this deck. Priest of Ancient Lore. Now, that's a good card. Don't have enough life gain yet to justify a unicorn, I would say. Rally Maneuver, that's certainly an interesting combat trick. Let's take it. Interesting. Get to look at their creature and land cards. You come to a null camp. Seems pretty good, actually. But we'll give this Orc Knight a go. Okay, we've run out of red and white cards. Let's have a little look at our deck. I think we can go for the low to the ground aggro deck. Take out the expensive cards, take out this expensive 1/1 ramp card. So we've got 16 cards left. Probably take the thing that we can splash. Right, let's take that one. Another Ranger Squadron. Oh, yeah, something on watch. Yeah, maybe that one. It's pretty good as well, the +1/+1. This is complicated. Exile a card from your hand and put a number of time counters on it equal to its mana value. When the last time counter is removed from this card, if it's exiled, you may cast it without paying its mana cost. If you cast a creature spell this way, it gains haste till end of turn. And then remove a time counter from each other card you own in exile. It's pretty sweet. Perpetually loses all ability. This might be a good way of stripping double team off things, even if you can't kill them. That unicorn's pretty good. Take the unicorn, I think. Oh yeah, we've got another unexpected allies, which is does seem really good. I need to try and pick one of those at some point. Another battle cry goblin, that's what we want to see. There's nothing amazing here. Battle cry goblin wins easy there. Target creature control gets double strike. Seems good. Don't bring a cleric. How many creatures are we at? Oh. Only got 10 creatures. What's going on? Yeah, my creature deck didn't get many creatures yet, and I want to get a two-handed axe as well. But we've got these big creatures if we need them. Steadfast Unicorn or a Flaming Fist Dusk Guard. Yeah, I think we'll skip the two-handed axe for now and grab a creature. Cool, it's a removal spell that summons a creature. Seems very good. This guy, Ambergris. So maybe that's more mid-rangey, that's sort of 4 mana. This is 3 mana. You can discard your hand and draw 2 cards. That's really good for an aggro deck. There's the War Caller there, which is quite tempting, but I think we want to try Ambergris. More creatures, more removal. This seems really good, but I've already got, two of those. I think we just start taking more creatures whenever we can. Yeah, no creatures. Let's try the Null Camp. Creatures. Goblin Trap Finder. Hobgoblin Captain. Yes. And Steadfast Paladin. So this is where all the creatures were hiding. Hobgoblin Captain seems good. Mace of Disruption. Never used one before. Always see it. Unicorns, or a Dawnbringer Cleric. It feels very sort of defensive, Dawnbringer Cleric. We've got two unicorns. Let's go for the cleric. Right. How many cheap creatures did we end up getting? Oh, 17. Perfect. That's exactly the right number. So we won't have to go for big creatures, it looks like. We are not sure about ambushed on the road. Or a mace of disruption. Let's go back. Well, okay, let's drop Mace of Disruption for now. We like this one. 5 damage to attacking creatures is good. We like Fiend Lash. Got the Knoll Camp. Is that good? Yes, I think it is. Liara's good. Guiding Bolt, good. Priest. Rally Maneuver. Ambergris. Citadel Ancient to refill the hand. So, this is a good ambush. Your ambush on the road. You can protect your creatures. You can balance them and get another come into play effect, which works with Priest of Ancient Lore and Dawnbringer Cleric. And Flaming Fist Dusk Guard as well. I don't think it's that great. Rally Maneuver. I don't usually play many combat tricks. Maybe this is a good one. Because I could replace it with Scouting Hawk to get another creature. I guess what this deck is missing is card draw, which is usually a problem with Boros. Well, yeah, of course, we're on 44 cards as well. In which case, yeah, we probably do drop Rally Maneuver. Ambergris is there to refill the hand. I think we can drop to 16 land and then drop two more things. So I think when in doubt, drop the combat tricks. This could win me a few games. You come to the Knoll Camp. So could you hear something on watch? Maybe we don't need Dueling Rapier. I do like it, but maybe we drop that and we'll drop one of the. You hear something on watch. Yeah, okay. I think I'm pretty happy with that. 15 two drops. Sure. 17 creatures. Let's go. Let's try this out. One thing we're missing, we never picked up one of those kobold war callers. Two white land, five red cards. Not quite what we want. Okay, that's fine, and we can drop a mountain. That can be open hand, someone else, maybe with the same idea. Opening with, I think, a Flaming Fist Dusk Guard. He took the Gorian Wise Mentor. Interesting. I think I kind of like the idea of a Dawnbringer Cleric with an extra point of power. 2-3 is much better than 1-3. We've got to swing in though, see if he blocks. We're only taking out a 1-1, but that's something, and we get to follow up with the creature, so that's pretty cool. That gets to be 2-2. Now, how many adventure cards did this guy manage to get? Yeah, he got the young blue dragon one. Nice. This guy gets Vigilance as well. It's kind of fun playing against the card that we decided to skip. Go Battlecry Goblin. No attacks. But yeah. Definitely pretty good to stop aggro. You know, a 3-4 creature on turn 3. Definitely helps. So, about another Battlecry Goblin. Do we need to exile anything from the graveyard? I think we gained 2 life because we're about to take lots of damage. Oh, I didn't notice he was attacking that for some reason. I was wondering what he got. Before, yeah. I think he's figured out this whole business with aggro decks. Just play lots of 3-4 creatures. One attack though. So that can get bigger as well. It is looking like a bit of a waste, this one, using it to kill a 1/1. But never mind. So yeah, not attacking that guy at least, so that's something. Right, Priest of Ancient Lore. Do we want to play this or pump the team and attack? Do we want to... use that ability. I think we'll do Priest of Ancient Lore, to be honest with you. We don't need to be rash, I would say. Okay, Monk of the Open Hand. I think we keep him in the hand until we can double spell. Makes sense. Everything up to 4/5. Okay. So, I think you're gonna go there with a Dawnbringer Cleric. Put another Dawnbringer Cleric there. I think, yeah, we'll try and retain the goblins. So, we'll do that combination to block the Water Weird. Hopefully he doesn't have another pump spell. But he, you know, chances are he probably does, but we'll try that. Okay, so that one gets to kill two things, right. Okay, that's his combat trait. Very, very happy to see Mephit's enthusiasm. We could take out the 4/4 on the ground or the flyer, but we can pump our team, basically. I think, yeah, let's get a monk of the open hand, if it's enthusiasm, the flyer. So we can't block flyers. No attacks. And yeah, definitely using that ability would be good on Priest of Ancient Law. Oh, the Naga. Okay, an even bigger creature. Sure. We actually do like a land drop with all these pump abilities. So that's going to get them to 5 power. So I think we just want to draw a card with our priest. We just but we can double pump the goblins. Yeah, that gets them to 5. We've already figured that out. So it's not as big as a Guardian Naga. Never mind. We just got to draw cards. Let's target him. Attack. Right. So if we get, as soon as we get a mountain, we can actually. So that thing is indestructible. I think let's chuck the cleric and the monk in front of the devoted paladin. See if he has some combat trick. Oh yeah, I'm on, by the way, I'm on 8 life. didn't notice that little detail. Kind of in trouble at this point. That gets to be a 3/3 now. It's just been, yeah, big creature. Big creatures from turn 3 onwards. But yeah, definitely looks like a huge misplay to use Null Camp just to kill the 1/1 creature. I think I had to hold that until he blocked with his big creature. Oh, that's pretty sweet. Okay, so Battlecry Goblin can be pumped to 6 power. Trouble is, the Flaming Fist Warrior is going to trade off one of them. I think we will Priest of Ancient Lore. Oh yeah, that gets to be slightly bigger. Get another mountain. Sure. I suppose on the plus side, we're getting to see how you deal with these aggro decks. You just have really efficient, tough creatures. That becomes a 3/4 as well. So everything in this deck is 3/4. Destroy artifact or enchantment. And then plus one counters on two other target creatures. That's nice. Why didn't that take effect? Why didn't he get his counters? Okay, so we have to block now. Pass two blockers. This has got 4 power, so it can take on Jahira. Okay, Battlecry Goblin will have to just trade for Flaming Fist Officer, and a Dawnbringer Cleric will jump in the way there. Not ideal, but there you go, that's how it is. This thing's pretty brutal, all told, if you don't have a removal card. So, to recap, that can get to power 5. This will take it to power 6. Why not? Want to attack at least once. Oh, I've forgot to do this at the right time, so I didn't get my goblin. Silly me. But it would have been a tapped goblin. This is the guy we want to chop one with. Well, it's pretty good to see just a Guardian Naga completely taking over a game, because I've had this a couple of times and not played it. Okay. It does 2 damage. Unfortunately, we're going to die to this. Even if we make a goblin, we can only get to 3 damage. Let's pump his ability. So let's see if we get. I think the timing of this. Yeah, you have to pump it pre-combat to get your goblin. So we're learning how this works, I suppose. So that's something. Okay, let's see. Let's take double team off that. It's a 3-colour big creatures deck he had there, and it just got a good start. Hit the right land, 3-4 on turn 3, which can just completely shut down my deck. I did have the answer in my hand, and I wasted it. So, my fault, I think. But he had a string of big creatures ready to go, so I think he'd have still stabilised the board. Okay, well, I've got the Guiding Bolt there. That's what I was hoping for. So playing clerics for beatdown, but what are you gonna do? Obviously, it's not going perfectly here. We would have liked to draw a third land. Then we can draw a card, of course, with this guy. Interesting. What is this? Gets you the gates, right. Very cool. We can get through with one damage. I think that's definitely a plan. So that's 10 cards, 2 lands so far. Nice. third land. Still, he's had... I mean, he's hit all three colours of mana, but I'd say this looks like a slow start. I mean, he's playing... This is a ramp card, I guess. This is an equipment card. So he's probably a little lower on creatures than I am, I guess. He's got big creatures, so... I can actually do that 4 damage with the humiliation. We'll just kill it with Guiding Bolt, which seems pretty good. Actually look for some land. Two mountains on top, that'll do nicely. This card's starting to look good. 4 damage. Oh, he just took all my lands off the top. That really sucks. He had a bloomin' mill card. He's got... You hear something on watch, so he can do 5 damage to one of my guys. Fair enough. So that's doing my mountains gone. We've all got exiled, yeah. How many mountains have I got left? 6. 6 in 23 cards. So it's about a 25% chance each turn I'll get a mountain. Yeah, he's dead. But, yeah. Interesting. Not a card I'd play myself. It's worked out for him. He managed to find a removal spell. Okay. He's got a lot of combat tricks in his deck. Well, we're gonna right to hold this back, I think. We're gonna respond like that. Another ramp card. So just notice the pattern here. He's got an equipment card, he's got 2 ramp cards, he's got a couple of combat trick type cards. So the creature count's low, I would say. He's probably got like 10 or 11 creatures in the deck. And maybe he might have proper removal here. Okay, it was funny, we might even have to discard cards at this rate. We've got plenty of ways to get non-land cards, so you should have some action soon. So we lost 2 lands off the top, so it's been 5 land in 18 card. Well, we've got 18 cards, we've got another Plains. It's not perfect. Means we don't have to discard for another turn, I suppose. So there should be 6 mountains in there. It's getting close to a 33% chance we're going to find a mountain each turn. There we go. Speak of the devil. So, 20 cards into the deck. We managed to get our third mountain, but our first mountain that we can play, which didn't get milled off the top. So, now things are really going to get crazy. We can play a haster for 3 damage. Seems like the best one. I'll decline. Might just do something spectacular soon. Okay, he's got removal, minimus containment. It's another source of red mana, mind you. Reckless Barbarians, they're just the 2/2 you can sacrifice. So what are the highest impact guys I could... So I could play a Battlecry Goblin and give it haste. Don't think it's the best thing to do. We'll do. Actually, turn 1 red mana into 2 red mana with Reckless Barbarian as well. I think I'll do this the slow, boring way. He is a goblin. Okay, right. Let's say we do a Reckless Barbarian. Sack it for 2 red. Play a Battlecry Goblin. And... yeah, now that sounds like fun. Let's try this out. I hope I haven't miscalculated. Sacrifice you. Play a Battlecry Goblin. Please tap a white. Activate ability. I mean, this is lethal, you see, unless he's got something. So it's probably the best thing to do, you know. Well, we got there. 20 cards into the deck. We got to play our first mountain. So, and it... it really paid off for us. Ishin, 2 heavens as 1. Now, I thought I already had 4 copies of this one. So maybe I'm going to just get some gems. Maybe I only had 3. Okay, ah yes, we've got a cheap unicorn. Cool. Yeah, that all sounds good. Keep 7. Hopefully we've got, looks like a slightly faster start this time. We'll go with the Hobgoblin Captain first. Rather than Liara, so he'll soak up the removal, hopefully. agree would be more damage. Yeah, I think that makes sense. There isn't that much instant removal for 2 mana. He just gets first strike, doesn't he? It's pack tactics. So he did have the cast down. Sure enough, it did hit the Hobgoblin captain. Demogorgon's clutches. Pretty painful. I think we'll retain Liara, even though the priest is really good. Draws me a replacement card. So discard a mountain. Yeah, okay, we'll discard the priest. I think we'll get more value out of Liara. That's my theory. That's interesting because we could actually discard my hand and draw 2 cards. Sound plan. Okay, that can do some damage to me. Ghast can kill me, so we want to do that for 3 mana, and these for 4 mana. But just remember that these are free technically. We want, okay, Reckless Barbarian. Okay, I was thinking too long, clearly. But it's complicated. I've got cards I can cast and then sacrifice some mana. I think it would have worked. I think I'd have been able to cast both of those and the ability, given my haster first strike, and then discarded my 0 card hand and drawn 2 more cards. Broker's Ascendancy, cool. Very, very cool. Ah, we've seen our Fiendlash. It does cost 3 to equip. Yep, those are pretty cool. Think that is optional. Yeah. Very interesting. So I can actually save him with a Schwinger. Doesn't even get a treasure token. That's a shame. He does get to still get the double team. Right. Unicorn. Aura. Are we racing? I think we're racing here. Very nice. Okay, 3 damage. Good. Pop that one for 3 damage. And I think we'll play a Fiend Lash. That sounds very good indeed to me. This stops things blocking. Could pump all my creatures and give them vigilance. That just seems quite strong. But they can take out the unicorn. And they can't take out Liara. So just attack with Chwinga. So, we've always got this to take out two blockers. When we'll probably do about 5 damage. I think I'll go ahead, pump the unicorn, and attack those two. It's okay if the unicorn dies, because it should trade off for something. Cool. Okay, 4, 6. What he really needs is lifelink on it. That would make sense. That would be quite a good play. I've got some bad news for him next turn. Well, that deck worked pretty decently. Haven't named the deck yet. Let's come up with a snazzy name. For Flaming Fiendlash. There we go. Not that we ever equipped it, but it was, you know, it was there in spirit. Yeah, Steadfast Unicorn, pretty cool. Patriarch's Humiliation, really good in this kind of deck if you can pump out the creatures. Just, yeah, we really felt the six dropping the land, but it's the right deck to drop down to 16 land, I think. And Reckless Barbarian has got some interesting uses. Sort of easy, probably easy to overlook this card. It doesn't seem that exciting, but good when you want to empty your hand with Ambergris. It's basically a free card. Add that to the decks. Claim my prize. Okay, Icewind Stalwart. Nice. Okay, I think that is a video. I think I'll tell you what. I will do one more, but I will just concede because I might play the first three turns and just see what it looks like. This kind of thing can be quite a challenging event if you're not a drafter and you want to get those rare cards. I think it's it's nice to chuck in a concede here and there. But I think we'll play the first couple of turns. When I don't hit my third land drop, I can concede. Oh, there's a land drop. Okay, it might concede before I do. If anyone's activated this yet to draw two cards, probably someone has. I think I'm just going to concede that. Enjoy your victory. Right. Okay, right, that is the video. Thanks for watching.